Gloryseekers, hail the blood and sands, for glory only shines upon those left standing. The Arena of Solare is a matchmaking-based PvP content where you can test your skills against fellow adventurers in 3v3 matches using equalized gear. You can quickly access the Arena of Solare by going to the Escape menu, War, and Arena of Solare. However, your character must be at least level 60 and completed the Succession and Awakening questlines, so make sure you fulfill the requirements. In the Arena of Solare, you will use Arena of Solare exclusive gear rather than your personal equipment. You can set up this gear via the Set Gear button in the Arena of Solare menu. From this menu, you can set up your gear crystals as well. At the start, you'll only be able to use the default gear and crystals. By completing matches in the Arena of Solare, you can receive Seals of Solare, which will allow you to unlock additional gear and crystals beyond the default gear set. Excluding the stats you gain from gear, you will have the same stats as anyone else playing the same class, but consumables such as potions cannot be used in the arena. Instead, your character's default HP, MP, WP, and SP recovery will be greatly increased. After you set up your gear loadout, press the Find Match button to look for a match. Once you find a match, you will enter the Arena of Solare after every participant accepts the match. The Arena of Solare will randomly place you in one of the following battlefields: Olin's Valley, Ruins of Zol, or Areha Palm Forest. Olin's Valley is where you can test your skills without any other variables. Ruins of Zol is where the unknown sphere and traces of elements appear. Areha Palm Forest is where only the traces of elements appear. You'll need to figure out the best playstyle for each of these three battlefields to truly show off your skills. In the Arena of Solare, you can encounter the unknown sphere and trace of elements, which are meant to be tactically utilized. The unknown sphere that only appears in the Ruins of Zol will appear in different forms for each round. Each form will be represented by different colors and effects. The red and blue spheres will move around and cast AoE attacks. The red sphere's attack deals damage, while the blue sphere's attack applies a guard gauge recovery debuff. The green and black spheres both perform AoE attacks in a fixed area, but the green sphere's attacks apply an HP recovery effect. On the other hand, the black sphere's attacks apply a DP reduction effect and pull nearby targets inwards. As for the traces of elements, they can be destroyed for elemental buffs. Flora's breath recovers HP, water's chill increases DP, fire's warmth increases AP, and wind's song increases AP, attack, and casting speed. Keep in mind that except for Wind Song, you and your party members can also receive the effects of these elemental buffs. Utilizing these unknown spheres and traces of elements tactically is how you can gain the edge you need to claim victory. Your match points in the Arena of Solare will fluctuate depending on your results, and you will be awarded an Emblem of Solare depending on your point bracket. Once the season ends, you'll receive rewards according to the emblem achieved. You can also earn additional points for winning consecutively. So try to keep up a win streak. Glory awaits you. Test your skills in the Gear Equalized Arena of Solare. And that wraps up this basic overview of Black Desert's Arena of Solare. Until next time.